Okay, in this video I will describe a standard approach. It will not work in every airport, but it will work in most airports. So the first thing you want to do is to start to slow down from 300 knots to 250 knots when you approach flight level 100 or 10,000 feet. So here we are approaching our level and we start to reduce our speed. In this case, also there's a speed restriction at the lap, so we have to slow down anyway. The next thing you want to do is to make sure that you take into account any shortcuts and use the correct distance for your profile calculation accordingly. So there's no traffic here, so we can expect a shortcut to Sokan later on. So we are not using the 77 miles distance displayed in the MCU, but we will be using the distance to either the ILS or the VR. Okay, so let me skip ahead a bit here. So shortcut, and now we can do our altitude calculation or the profile calculation. So at 40 miles times 3, so flight level 120 minus 2,000 feet to slow down for our speed is 10,000 feet. So you can see that we are on profile, slightly below. And the next thing you want to do is to slow down from 250 to green dot speed when you approach, when you pass 5,000 feet. All these altitudes, by the way, they assume the airfield is at sea level. So here we are approaching 5,000 feet. And then you want to activate the approach phase if it's not activated already, and then start to, if your speed is selected, just select it to green dot speed, or if it's managed, you can just activate the approach phase and let the speed go down to green dot speed. Again, we're doing our profile calculation to make sure we're on profile. Because we are slowing down now, the profile calculation doesn't exactly add up, so you'll have to use either a speed in between those the 250 knots and green dot. So instead of 1,000 feet or 2,000 feet lower, you can use 1,500 feet lower, or you can wait for the next altitude check, which is at 15 miles. Okay, next what you want to do is to start to you select flap 1 at 15 nautical miles, and also change to vertical speed when passing 4,000 feet. This is just so you don't forget to open descent below 3,000 feet. So there's vertical speed. There's 15 miles. Flap 1 is selected. And what you want to do now is to place the aircraft 1 knot below the glide slope at S speed. And then when passing 3,000 feet, select flap 2. Now there are two different ways you can do this. You either fly level at 3,000 feet and then wait for the glide slope to come down at one dot and then select flap 1, or if you are still descending, like in this case, first you reduce your vertical speed so the aircraft will be at one dot below, and then you increase your vertical speed so it stays at one dot below. So let me just skip ahead a bit. So here we are one dot below the glide slope, and the vertical speed is increased to stay one dot below the glide slope. And then when the aircraft passes 3,000 feet, we will select flap 2. There's flap 2 selected. Usually the aircraft will balloon onto the glide slope. If it doesn't balloon onto the glide slope, then you can just reduce the vertical speed to force it onto the glide slope. There's glide slope star, so we can set our go-around altitude. Now we want to see when to lower the gear. If the speed is on the high side, so between the middle, like if this is the bottom, this is the top, the middle is right there. If the speed is on the high side here, you want to put the gear down at 2,500 feet. And if the speed is on the lower side, so from the middle here downwards, you want to put the gear down at 2,000 feet. So you can see already that the speed is on the lower side. So we can just wait until we pass 2,000 feet and lower the gear there. So we'll just skip ahead. So here is, we're approaching 2,000 feet. And then we can lower the gear, and after the gear is down and locked, we can select flap 3 and then flap 4. And that's usually at about 1800 feet where we can start selecting the flap 3 and flap 4. So there's flap 3 and flap 4. And then the aim is to be stable at 1500 feet. The maximum you can do is 1000 feet if you're in cloud or at night. So we don't want to be exactly stable at 1000 feet. It's better to be stable at 1500 feet. So that's it. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. Thank you.
If you like this video, please consider buying my book, Practical Descent Energy Management. It contains loads of examples of how to manage a descent and approach, and it is the only book available on this subject. There is a paperback and an ebook version available. You can find a link in the description below.